Hello. I just finished it. It's not quite razor sharp. It's got a fairly robust edge on it. And I just want to test it out a little bit, see what she's capable of. We'll lower it down just a little bit. There we are. There are nails, so we'll just have to do our best to miss them. But I'm just going to chop on it a little bit. I'm not going to swing too hard. Those are just light, easy swings. The edge is still there. There we go. Got through that bottle. So I got that. I ruined my newspaper, so I can't see if it's still sharp. I mean, it'll still cut hair. Let's try something else. And brushes. Cut that pretty easy. You see that? Yeah. Over here. I'm gonna move it over. And I'm not swinging hard or anything. Right here. And cut it. Onto it. Blade's still pretty good. Me and I chopped on that 2x4. I didn't chop hard, but you know. Let's go see if I find a better board. Alright, this is a fairly decent sized log. We'll just see if we can chop through it a little bit. It'll make it through that no problem. Wipe off all the material and edge looks good. Edge is sharp. And still cutting hair. Oh, and fingers. Okay, I got a low hanging branch. Let's see if I can take care of it. A little high, but we'll see. Here we go. It's not so bad at clearing brush. Oh, that's a hard one to do, huh? Oh, I didn't get it deep enough. There we go. The trick is if you want to cut a bottle or a can, have some weight at the bottom of it, not like water, and you want to hit it right here, just above where your fingers hold the knife. That way, when you bring it across, you get all that nice blade action right across it, and you'll be able to slice it. No problem.